Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Friday, December 6, 2013. We're coming up to 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, and right now stock index futures are above fair value. If they were to open at 9:30 where they are right now, we'd actually erase yesterday's losses. So quite a positive outlook at 7:30 a.m. On the East Coast, but we've got employment numbers coming out at 8:30 this morning, and that is certainly going to add some dramatic volatility to the futures in the pre-market. Now, commodity futures are down a little in the pre-market right now. Both crude oil and gold are below fair value, but we still have a couple hours to go before the market opens. Now, coming into this week's employment numbers, the market has a very bearish tone to it. And, you know, what we're seeing in the futures in the pre-market this morning doesn't reflect the overall market. You know, there's not a lot of people playing this time of day. It's mostly European and Asian traders that are playing the futures this time of day. So we'll have to wait and see how the market fares up after the employment numbers. But Thursday, while it was a negative day, was not that significant. It was actually an inside day for many of the major indexes and stocks. And so an inside day is a day of indecision. We couldn't take out Wednesday's high or low, and so we're looking on Friday to see if we take out Wednesday's high or low, and that should tell us where the market wants to go next. Now, options traders, this is the VIX for the Dow, the options traders have been very bearish coming into this week, and the VIX has been rising, and it was up again yesterday, even though it was an inside day. And so, you know, we called the VIX the fear index, and so options traders have been preparing for a negative reaction to today's employment numbers. This is the VIX for the S&P 500 that I watch every day. The S&P 500 actually generated a sell signal yesterday, and so you know, we'll have to wait and see how the market opens. If the market opens higher, then you get to sell into strength, and if it opens weaker, unfortunately, you get to sell into weakness. But it was actually an inside day yesterday, so the most significant thing is going to be Friday's close. Do we close above Wednesday's high or below Wednesday's low? Now, some of the other indexes that I watch, mid-cap stocks and the Russell 2000, we had an inside day there yesterday, still waiting for a sell signal. Similar situation to the Zacks microcap. Now, the NASDAQ's still holding up fairly well, and you're seeing weakness in the Dow and the S&P 500 because of weakness in the financial sector. And so we continue to see bank stocks move lower. They did not have an inside day yesterday. They actually made a lower low and closed near the low of the day. Now, while we're seeing some weakness in the Dow and the S&P 500, and that is a lot to do with financial services, the NASDAQ is still holding up very well, and one of the reasons is it's not focused on financial services. A lot of technology stocks and biotech stocks are trading up at the right-hand corner of the screen, and until these break down, you're not going to see a major acceleration to the downside for the overall market. It's going to be sector-specific, such as we're seeing in the banking sector right now. But you're not going to see a huge down move in the overall stock market when you've got stocks like Apple, Celgene, Linear Technology, Monster Beverage, Micron Technology, Yahoo, Autodesk, Expedia, Intuit. All of these stocks are still doing very well, trading up at the right-hand corner of the screen. And so it'll certainly be a tell if these stocks start to roll over and join the rest of the market that is currently having some struggles to move higher. Next up, looking at the Dow 30, it's a lot harder to find stocks that are winning at the moment. And while we have some that are still on buy signals, very few of them are trading up at the right-hand corner. You can see Disney peaked back here and then has been selling off for the last couple of days. Yesterday was actually a positive day, traded up to the upper channel line, closed in the middle of the channel. Still looking for a close on Friday below 69.77 to give us a sell signal. Nike has been trading in the channel for the last couple of days, has not closed below the lower channel line. Similar situation for American Express. Microsoft has had a couple of wild days and traded through the lower channel line on Thursday but did not close there, so still waiting for a sell signal there. New early warning signal for Visa, but still waiting for a close below the lower channel line. New buy signal actually for Intel on Thursday, so bucking the trend, joining the NASDAQ as opposed to the Dow. And Caterpillar is technically on a buy signal. It's not going anywhere. But it has been on a buy signal for over a week now and still looking to move higher. Now, if you were to ask me what are the biggest drags on the Dow right now, without checking, my intuition would tell me that it's probably a financial service related stock. But that is certainly not the case. And even with the NASDAQ holding up and making new highs up here, it happens to be a couple of technology stocks that are weighing down the Dow, and it's Cisco Systems and IBM. Both of those stocks traded lower yesterday, and both of them are the biggest drags on the Dow at the moment. Next up, let's take a look at commodity ETFs, and copper is currently on a buy signal. You know, I really don't want to have anything to do with copper. We still have the major band of resistance overhead, and I would love to see copper sell off more dramatically, give it a couple of weeks on the downside before, and to give us a lot more room between where we are right now and where the band of resistance is overhead. I'd certainly be more interested in copper then than I am now, which is zero. Looking at gold, it reversed Wednesday's gains. It's down a couple of bucks in the pre-market this morning. Platinum, quiet day yesterday, still on a sell signal. Similar situation for silver, inside day on Thursday. No chance of a buy signal on Friday. Crude oil actually closed up on the day, a little reversal there. But when you see a reversal, a potential top like this, the first thing I look for is, what did we do? Did we take out the previous day's low on the come down? And that is certainly not the case. So a reversal there, we closed higher on the day, but not looking for a major change in trend on Friday. Gasoline had an inside day yesterday, still holding the trend, and a nice big breakout for natural gas. And so it looks like we're running up to 2021 as our next target to the upside. And you can see back here that that was resistance back in July. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. Still projecting higher prices here for the VIX, and we've got a nice uptrend line. You can see the moving averages. These are the hourly, the 50, the 100, and the 200-hour moving average. They're all starting to move up, and so options traders are telling us that they think that the market is going lower. S&P 500 still hasn't broken down below the 200-hour, trading below the 100-hour at the moment, and the 50-hour is getting pretty close to rolling over on the 100-hour. Starting to trade below the flypaper channel, but we certainly have not broken away. Looking at a couple of price targets on Friday, 1796 on the upside, 1800 of course would be psychological resistance, and so if we do get a huge pop at the open, then a move up to 1800 wouldn't be unexpected. And then on the downside, if the market is disappointed by the numbers, and you know the numbers could be really good, and then the market could be disappointed by the really good numbers. So, you know, it's a little confusing how the market's going to handle the numbers today. But a move down to 1665 wouldn't be unexpected if they don't like the numbers on Friday. Looking up, we need a close, an hourly close above 1791.02 to give us a new intraday buy signal on Friday. And so that's 10.30, 11.30, 12.30, 1.30, 2.30, 3.30. If we close above that level any of those hours, that would be a new intraday buy signal on Friday. Okay, folks, that's all for me for this week. It's going to be an exciting hour between 8.30 and 9.30. I personally wouldn't do anything if I was trading the market today. I wouldn't do anything till after 10.30 to let the news sink in. And not only the news, but the reaction to the news. Let that sink in before taking on new positions. We're starting to see some weakness in the Dow and the S&P 500. That has not rolled over to the other major indexes. Still have a lot of technology and biotech stocks that are doing very well, holding the market up. Until those start to break down, we're not going to see an acceleration to the downside outside of anything related to financial services. But the options traders are certainly telling us that they're expecting lower prices. So, you know, that's where I'm leaning right now. Is options traders, the VIX indexes have been rising ahead of these employment numbers, and so they're expecting the market to fall. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and next time we'll talk is on Monday morning.